Maybe this is a baking tutorial you've been looking for. Today I will show you how to prepare high poly, low poly, set baking groups by using names, and how to fix the most common issues. I'll show everything on example of my body camera asset. This is how it looks like. And here is an example of how low poly looks before baking normal maps and after. This is the most important map on appearance of the model. But we will also bake all necessary maps for texturing. More on that later. We are going to bake in the Marmoset tool bag. If you never use that, don't worry, I will show you. It's easier than it looks. You don't have to worry about the program version either. It doesn't matter much for baking. I hope you already know what the baking is and why you need it. For the purposes of this tutorial, I'm assuming you already know how to make high poly and low poly. I'll focus on preparing them for the baking. Let's start with high poly. Assign smooth shading to the all meshes. Make sure there are no sharp edges. Assign high poly material to everything. I recommend using a metal looking shader. It will show all shading errors. Apply the transforms. The main thing is to apply rotation and scale. Check if there are any reverted normals on your geometry. I recommend keeping all high poly elements in separate meshes. Don't apply subdivision modifier. Leave it active so you can edit geometry. It will be applied automatically on export. You don't need to do AUVs. Don't worry about it at all. For the high poly, that's it. Simple, isn't it? Now let's move on to the low poly. The process is similar, but has differences. Let's get into it. Remove all the informations of the edges. Take down creases, bevel weights, seams, and sharps. Sometimes this is left over from the modeling stage, and we don't need it anymore. Triangulate any n-gons. Use triangulation modifier with a minimum vertex value of 5. This way you triangulate all n-gons, but you don't touch a quads. Apply smooth shading to everything. Manually arrange the sharp edges. Shading on low poly is just as important as on high poly. Mark all sharp edges as seams. This is very important. Apply the transforms. Also, the most important is to apply rotation and scale. Assign the low poly material to everything. Name it the same as the asset. I recommend using a bright color of the material for the viewport. This will help you better visualize the matching of high poly and low poly geometries. Check to see if there are any reverted normals on your geometry. Make a funnel UV, add seams where they needed. That's it for low poly. A little bit more complicated, but nothing unbelievable either. Separate topic on how the high poly and low poly geometries should match. They should match as close as possible. It's crucial. Your high poly and low poly must match exactly. Same position, same scale. If you see Z fighting at big surfaces, that's a good thing. There is a situation where it's not possible, such as baking cylinders. Try to make the top and the bottom of the cylinder match the catch of the fighting, but the sides should intersect with a wave. you should be able to see 50-50 parts of the high poly and low poly. It will end up looking something like this. Now we need to assign correct names. The low poly and high poly meshes must have the same name, just different suffixes. This way you bake the correct pairs. To bake by groups, you need to prepare naming. Underscore low suffix for low poly, underscore high for high poly. I start by renaming all meshes related to the low poly. This can be done manually, or you can use built-in batch rename function. But I prefer to use the simple renaming tool add-on. I select all parts of the low poly, specify a name, for example, body camera, and click replace names. Now we need to add a suffix to all names. I find the field at the bottom where I specify the suffix, underscore low, and click add suffix. I'm doing the same thing with high poly, only now I specify underscore high in the suffix. Unfortunately, in this approach, the digits in names of high poly and low poly do not match. It's necessary to go through and manually correct the names so that identical parts of low poly and high poly have the same names and digits. Only suffixes are different. It's often the case that several high poly elements must be baked into a single low poly. In such a case, we should give the same name to all parts of high poly, and to avoid conflicts, we should add ordinary digits after the suffix. It would look something like this. That way, they will be placed in the same group. Before exporting our meshes, let's create new folders that we'll be using for our new bake. Create a folder bake. Inside it, there are two more folders. Meshes, where we will store our FBX files, and outputs folder. We'll use it for storing baked textures. Let's return to the export. Separately exporting high poly and low poly meshes to the previously created meshes folder. Don't forget to check selected only checkbox when exporting. In my case, I will have two files there named bodycamera underscore low.fbx, bodycamera underscore high.fbx. Run Marmoset toolbag and immediately save our project to the bake folder. Add the baker to the scene, toaster icon. Now in the settings of the baker, find the quick loader. Click load, choose low and high FBX in the meshes folder, and the scene will be assembled automatically. Check that high and low models align perfectly. Now it's time to customize the bake. Use these settings to get started. At first we bake only normal map. If the first bake isn't perfect, don't worry, we'll fix it next. You need to paint skew correction. Go to low, click paint skew. Turn flow to maximum. Then paint over the details. They will be updated in real time. To avoid visual artifacts, you should avoid painting on the hard edges of the model with the brush. Once your normal map is clean, bake additional maps. Here is a full list of them. Normal, normal object, position, curvature, ambient occlusion, object ID. If you don't see any of these maps listed, they need to be activated by clicking on a configure. I also recommend increasing the number of rays to 2048 in the AO settings. Bake is ready. Yeah, that's easy. Common baking problems. If the textures looks pixelated or very blurry, it's worth to check the texture density and increase the resolution of the baked textures. The noticeable seam on the edge could be because you used a sharp edge but didn't assign a seam to it. Gradients on a normal map are often caused by not placing hard edges on a straight or sharp corners of low poly. Black strips on edges or missing bevels appear on the edges of the model, often with no baked bevels on the back of the edges. This is caused by improper fitting the high poly and low poly. Parts missing from the bake. The reason is naming error. It's necessary to check name spelling. The high poly and low poly match, but the bake looks displaced. You need to check that the normals are not reverted. Another cause of visible seam on the later stages of the baking is improper painting of skew correction. Avoid skew correction across UV borders. Part of the high poly shape is not fully baked on low poly. The cage is too small. Increase it in the low poly group settings in Marmoset. Messy bake. Parts from some objects appear in random places of other objects. The reason is that packing UVs is incorrect. Everything must be on one UV set. Avoid unnecessary overlapping of UV shells. That's it. Now you know how to bake textures in Marmoset toolbag. All files related to this video will be uploaded on my ArtStation. There you can download them and experiment on your own. If you're curious about making full asset from scratch, then check my hand-plane 3D asset course. Links are in description. Available on Gumroad, ArtStation and Udemy. If this video was helpful, please subscribe. See you in the next video.